Okay, an alternative way to approach this problem is to write the function we're given in the form a cosine omega x plus phi plus b, where the only thing that's important about this is that the coefficient of x, omega, called the angular frequency, is always positive. And we discussed in class that if the coefficient of x did happen to be negative, we could factor a negative out and use the even identity for cosine to get rid of it. So if I proceed in this manner, I need to get the cosine term first. So I get a minus 1 cosine, and then I'm going to distribute this 1 half through 1 half x minus pi over 2 plus 3. Or to be overly pedantic about it, to put it in this form, I have negative 1 cosine 1 half x plus negative pi over 2 plus 3. So I'm writing the cosine first. In there, I'm writing the x first, adding all these constants. So from here, I can read off a is negative 1, omega is 1 half, phi is minus pi over 2, and b is 3. And then I can use these formulas. I know that the amplitude is the absolute value of a, which in this case is the absolute value of negative 1, which is 1. I know that the period is going to be 2 pi over omega, which is 2 pi, in this case, over 1 half, which is 4 pi. And the phase shift is minus phi over omega, so it's minus negative pi over 2 divided by 1 half. And that's going to give me a positive pi. Now the b is the baseline. Y equals 3 is the new baseline. So the way we put all this together to graph it is we start with the phase shift. The phase shift is positive pi. That means I'm going to start pi units to the right of 0. The period is 4 pi. So that means that the end of this cycle is going to be 4 pi units later. So I add 4 pi, that's going to get me to 5 pi. Now to determine the quarter marks, I just average these two. Pi plus 5 pi over 2 is 6 pi over 2, that's 3 pi. That's going to give me the point right here in the middle. And now I average these two. Pi plus 3 pi over 2 is 4 pi over 2, which is 2 pi. That gives me the number in the middle here. And last but not least, 3 pi plus 5 pi over 2 is 8 pi over 2. That's 4 pi. That gives me the number right there. Okay, so if I know the phase shift and the period, that's how I get the new quarter marks. Now I use the fact the baseline is y equals 3. I'm going to dot that in. The amplitude is 1, so that means that this curve is going to oscillate 1 unit above and below the baseline. But since the a here is a negative 1, the cosine curve is going to be reflected. So we're going to start 1 unit below the baseline. And then we're going to follow the pattern to the baseline, above the baseline, back to the baseline, and then below the baseline, 1 unit. And so then we connect that up. And if you trace through here and look at the points, we get the same points we got before. Pi comma 2, 2 pi comma 3, 3 pi comma 4, 4 pi comma 3, and 5 pi comma 2. All right, so that's the second way to do it. In either case, that'll do it for number 1.